Welcome on into Pickswise Playbook Thursday Night Football Preview. Lauren Jabari here with Jared Smith. Tank Williams is presented by Superbook Sports, and we're going to break it all down right now. The Titans heading up to Green Bay, Lambeau Field, to take on the Green Bay Packers. And the Packers, they're fighting for their playoff survival at this point, coming off the best win of the year against the Cowboys, snapped a five-game losing streak. And the Titans are coming off of a come-from-behind win against the Broncos. Now they're two games ahead, sitting at the top of the AFC South. And they are still the underdogs in this spot, guys. The Packers are laying the 3 points here. Tank, what is going on in Green Bay right now? Because I know you said they were your biggest surprise of week 10.
Definitely a surprise. I really didn't know when they were going to be able to set the bottom. It didn't seem like it was going to be likely against the Dallas Cowboys team that has one of the better defenses in the league. And then we saw what Tony Pollard was able to do in that Dak and CeeDee Lamb were finding their rhythm together. But somehow, some way, Aaron Rodgers and that Packers squad, they were able to pull out a dub. And I think a lot of it had to do with them running the ball effectively. They finally got some big explosive plays out of their young wide receivers, specifically Christian Watson. And so when you kind of spin it forward to this week, do you anticipate like some of those things kind of continuing on, or they're going to, you know, just have this one little small blip and then continue to fall down? I think that the defense should be able to tighten up a little bit. I think they'll just find a little bit of motivation, seeing that the offense finally responded for them. A lot of times you get in the locker room and the defense is like really solid, but if the offense isn't giving you anything, you end up having some lackluster play on your side of the ball, and then everything just starts to trend downward. But I think seeing the life come to Aaron Rodgers, seeing the life come to Aaron Jones, seeing the life come to Christian Watson, who every time the ball goes up in the air, you just expect to be like, oh, he's going to drop it. But he actually caught a few of those balls and had one of his biggest days. I think that's going to build a lot of momentum for Green Bay. And on the flip side, Tennessee coming in, leading that AFC South. Derrick Henry had himself a pedestrian game, 19 carries, 53 yards. Do we really see that continue this week? I don't think so. I think they get back on track with their run game. I mean, my man Ryan Tannehill had 255 pass yards, two TDs. We already talked about the Nick Westbrook-Akina explosion against the Denver Broncos. Do I foresee that coming again this week against the Green Bay defense? No. But I think that the Titans should be able to generate enough points on offense just by riding King Henry. All that being said, not sure who wins this game. I think it'll be a competitive game, but I feel pretty comfortable on the over, especially when you think about the injuries that Tennessee's going dealing with right now. I'm not sure if Jeffrey Simmons is going to be back. Like, if some of these guys return, it may make me want to kind of consider the under. But I think with Green Bay finding a little something on offense and Tennessee trying to get their running game back on track, things to me are trending towards an over 41 in this matchup.
Yeah, Derrick Henry's been a force to be reckoned with. He only needs 77 more yards to hit 1,000 rushing for this season. But the Titans haven't allowed more than 20 points in a game since week 3. Defense has 13 takeaways, 29 sacks. They could be coming for Aaron Rodgers. They're hungry right now. Would you trust, Jared, the Packers laying 3 points at home at Lambeau Field?
So this is starting to trend towards, excuse me, towards 3.5. And
wow.
I think it makes sense if you consider some of the injury concerns for Tennessee. Their center, Ben Jones, had a concussion. You have got multiple players on the defensive side, Simmons, Dupree, Hooker, McCreary, all questionable. Short week, second consecutive road game. Or excuse me, no, they were at home last week. Short week, though, on the road. So you've got some trends working against Tennessee there on the injury front and on the, you know, the day of the game. I'd love to buy into this Packers team, because I think if they can, and winning cures all in the NFL, right? And I think if they could string a few wins together, you start to think very differently about this Green Bay team, because the NFC is wide open and you could still call this a buy low spot. This game opened Packers 5.5 over the summer. And obviously the ratings have shifted considerably since. Green Bay has sunk and Tennessee has kind of risen. I have no idea how the Titans won that game on Sunday. They were down double digits. They couldn't establish the run. And Tannehill had one of the worst completion percentages of his entire career, like over expectation. Like, it was really bad. I mean, and again, two lightning strike plays to Nick Westbrook-Akina, and all of that is forgotten because the Broncos are just completely inept. So I'm not very bullish on this Titans offense right now. Now, that being said, the Packers can't stop the run. 30th in DVOA. The Cowboys ran it really well against them. And the Titans defense, minus the injuries I mentioned, have been pretty stout against the run this year. So I think there's some interesting conflicting data here. I think Tennessee, to me, at 3.5 would be the side. At 3, I kind of favor Green Bay. So I think the number matters, and we'll see where it closes on Thursday.
It's going to be interesting to see Thursday Night Football, Titans at Lambeau taking on the Packers. We'll see you then. Until then, make sure to check out Pickswise Playbook presented by Superbook Sports. That is Tank Williams. This side. That is Jared.
Yes, I am. There we go. There we go.
We'll see you guys on Pickswise Playbook Week 11, guys.
Do a dab.